stood on an island in the middle of a big blue lake. The house was surrounded by tall trees and green grass, and inside this house there lived a man. But this man was not a happy man. His favorite thing to do was to grumble. He grumbled that the grass was too green. He grumbled that the trees were too tall. And he grumbled that the lake was too big and blue. He had only one friend in the whole world, his cat. This cat was a happy cat. His favorite thing to do was to play. He played in the green grass. He played up the tall trees. And he played near the big blue lake. After he'd finished playing, and the man had finished grumbling for the day, the cat would jump up onto the man's lap and curl up for a nap. One day, the happy cat began to feel sad. He wanted friends to play with, and he wanted the man to have other friends too. The house and the island and the lake felt so big and lonely with just the two of them. So he decided to leave the house on the island in the middle of the lake in search of some friends for himself and the man. That evening, after the man had finished his grumbling, he waited for the cat to jump up onto his lap. When the cat didn't come, he grumbled even more. He grumbled and grumbled, but the cat didn't come. Soon the man began to feel very lonely indeed, and started to worry about where his cat might be. He searched high and low, but there was no sign of him anywhere. The man knew he must go and look for him. So he opened his front door and stepped outside. He walked down the path to the edge of the big blue lake where he kept his old boat, and he set sail across the water. The wind blew and the sails billowed, and he skimmed across the lake until he reached the other side. He couldn't remember when he had last been this far from home. He stepped off the boat into a green field and began to walk. He walked on and on through field after field. Soon, he began to feel very tired.
"Oh, this is no good," the man grumbled. "Maybe I should turn around and go back home."
But just then, the man heard a noise behind him. He whirled around. There, in front of him, stood a horse.
"Can I help you?" asked the horse.
"No," grumbled the man. "I feel very tired and I am trying to find my cat."
"I met a very friendly cat only yesterday," said the horse. "He headed towards the hills. I can give you a ride if you like, and then you can go on your way."
The man was about to grumble again, but realizing how much his legs were aching, he accepted the horse's offer, and on they went. After the man had said goodbye to the horse at the foot of the hills, he began to walk again. He walked on and on, climbing hill after hill. Soon, he began to feel very thirsty.
"Oh, this is
she turn around and go back home. But just then, the man heard a noise behind him. He whirled around. There, in a pond below him, sat a duck. "Can I help you?" asked the duck. "No," grumbled the man. "I feel very thirsty and I am trying to find my cat." "I met a very friendly cat only yesterday," said the duck. "He headed towards the forest. I can give you some water if you like, and then you can go on your way." The man was about to grumble again, but realizing how dry his mouth was, he accepted the duck's offer, and on he went. He walked on and on, past tree after tree. Soon he began to feel very hungry. "Oh, this is no good," the man grumbled. "Maybe I should turn around and go back home." But just then, the man heard a noise behind him. He whirled around. There, in the tree above him, sat a squirrel. "Can I help you?" asked the squirrel. "No," grumbled the man. "I feel very hungry and I am trying to find my cat." "I met a very friendly cat only yesterday," said the squirrel. "He headed up the mountain. I can give you some nuts if you like, and then you can go on your way." The man was about to grumble again, but realizing how much his stomach was rumbling, he accepted the squirrel's offer, and on he went. He climbed and climbed, and climbed and climbed. Up the mountain he went, until he came to an opening in the side of the mountain. Taking a deep breath, but without grumbling, the man crept into the cave. He crept along a dark passageway, and as he turned a corner, he saw a faint light glowing in the distance. He started to feel scared, but he knew he had to keep going. Very slowly, he crept, and as he got nearer and nearer to the light got brighter and brighter until he could see that it was a fire burning. And there beside it, curled up, was it? Yes, it was his cat. As the man came closer, the cat stirred, and at seeing the man, ran to meet him.
"I'm so glad you came,"
purred the cat.
"I've made so many new friends. Have you met the dragon yet who lives in the cave?"
"A dragon?" gasped the man.
"Oh, don't worry, it's a nice dragon," the cat assured him. "It invited me into its cave for tea and asked me all about my adventure. So I told it all about my friends. The squirrel who lives in the forest, and the duck who lives in the pond, and the horse who lives in the field, and the man, that's you, who lives in a house in the middle of an island in the middle of a big blue lake."
"Where is it now?" asked the man.
"I don't know," said the cat, looking around him. "I've had such a busy time playing with all of my new friends, I decided to have a quick nap."
"You silly cat," cried the man. "Don't you know you should never trust the dragon? Quick, we need to hurry back." The man and the cat hurried back down the mountain to the forest. But the trees were gone. The poor squirrel told them that a dragon had flown from the mountain and burnt the trees with its flames.
"Quickly, quickly, come with us," said the man.
And on they ran. The man and the cat and the squirrel hurried back through the burned forest to the pond. But the water was gone. The poor duck told them that a dragon had flown from the forest and dried up his pond with its flames.
Quickly, quickly, come with us, said the man.
And on they ran. The man and the cat and the squirrel and the duck hurried back over the hills to the fields. But the grass was gone. The poor horse told them that a dragon had flown from the hills and burnt the grass with its flames.
Quickly, quickly, come with us,
said the man. And on they ran. The man and the cat and the squirrel and the duck and the horse hurried back across the burnt fields to the boat. But the boat was gone. The man supposed the dragon must have burnt that too. At the edge of the big blue lake, they could see the house in the middle of the island. And sure enough, flying high above it was an enormous dragon.
Quick, shouted the horse, climb on my back, I'll swim across to the island.
They all climbed on, as the horse was bigger and stronger than any of them, and within moments they had reached the other side. The dragon had started circling lower and lower. The flames were about to reach the house. Suddenly, the dragon stopped, startled. Something had hit its nose, and again. Then something hit its eye. The squirrel had dashed up one of the trees and had started to throw as many nuts as he could find at the dragon. It seemed to be working. But the next moment, the dragon had spread its wings and started to fly towards the squirrel. In a flash, the duck had flown up and darted in front of the dragon. He flew round and round its head. The dragon looked furious and dashed at the duck. The duck soared upwards and then plunged down into the big blue lake. The dragon dived down after him. The man and the cat and the squirrel and the horse watched and waited. The duck popped back up into view and swam calmly back to the island to join them. The man and the cat and the squirrel and the horse and the duck watched and waited. Slowly, bubbles started forming on the surface of the lake. Then they saw the dragon's wings, its body, its head. They held their breath. The dragon opened its mouth and blew. But this time, no flames came out. He blew and blew, but it was no good. The dragon's flames had been put out. They were safe. The dragon, realizing it had lost, spread its wings one last time and flew away, disappearing far into the distance. None of them knew where it went. But it didn't much matter, as a dragon with no flames was really no dragon at all. The man turned to his new friends.
Thank you, he said. Thank you for saving my beautiful house and this beautiful island with its green grass and tall trees and this beautiful big blue lake. I'm sorry about your homes, but I would love it if you all came to live here with me and my cat. And that is what they did. The squirrel enjoy climbing the tall trees.
Enjoy grazing in the green grass.